Hi guys, I'm Seema and today we're going to study about HCF and LCM. I'll be making many more useful videos on topics related to Quant, Reasoning and English for Phase 1 of RBI and SEBI. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and for regular updates hit the bell icon. Let us quickly revise some basic concepts. As you must be knowing, HCF is highest common factor and LCM is least common multiple. So let us assume two numbers, 16 and 24. We can write 16 as, and we can express 24 as. Now we see for HCF, this is the common part. Hence, HCF would be 2 cubed, that is 8. And for LCM, we'll first write the common part and then the part which is not common. Prime numbers. Prime numbers are numbers that are only divisible by 1 or themselves. Like 7, 3, 5, 11, 17, and so on. Natural numbers. Natural numbers start from 1 till infinity. Whole numbers. Whole numbers are nothing but extended form of natural numbers. They start from 0. Otherwise, they're same as natural numbers. Just the difference is they start with 0. Co-prime numbers. When the HCF of two numbers is 1, they are known as co-prime numbers. Now we are going to discuss the divisibility rules. So, as we all know, for 2 it is very easy. If the number is even, it is divisible by 2. For 3, the sum of digits should be divisible by 3. For 4, we divide the last 2 digits by 4, and if they are divisible by 4, then the whole digit is divisible by 4. For example, 2064. Just because this 64 is divisible by 4, we know that this number is divisible by 4. For 5, last digit has to be 0 or 5. For 6, it has to be an even number. Its sum should be divisible by 3. For 8, we have to divide the last 3 digits by 8, and if they are divisible by 8, then for 9, the sum of digits should be divisible by 9. For 10, the last digit should be 0. Now let us solve some questions. Question 1. 3 numbers which are co-prime to one another are such that the product of first 2 is 551 and that of last 2 is 1073. The sum of 3 numbers is, in the question it is given that these numbers are co-prime, which means their HCF is 1. Let the numbers be A, B and C respectively. So according to question, A multiplied by B is equals to 551 and B multiplied by C is equals to 1073. Equation 1, equation 2. So as we see, both of them are odd numbers. So we know one thing for sure, that odd number multiplied by an odd number gives an odd number. All 3 of them, they have to be odd numbers. And in the question, it is given that they are co-prime and odd numbers as well. On dividing equation 1 by equation 2, we get 551 upon 173. And now we have to find the factors of both of these. As on first look, we cannot easily find the factors of 551 and 1073. We will try and find the factors of the nearest number, which is 550 in case of 551 is 11 into 50, and 1075 in the case of 1073, which is 25 into 43. Now we have to find the prime numbers in this range, 11 to 50. Prime numbers in 11 to 50 range are 11, 13, 17, 19, 23, 29, 31, 37, 41, 43, and 47. As we see that the last digit here is 1, 1 into 1 gives the last digit as 1. After that, 3 into 7 gives 1. 9 into 9 gives 1. Here we have to see the pairs. Let's see for 1, just 11, 41, and 31. 11 into 31 is not equals to 551, and similarly 11 into 41 is also not equals to 551. Now we'll see for 3 and 7. No, this pair doesn't match. Similarly, this doesn't match as well. When we see 19 into 29, we get 551. And now we'll see for 1073. For 1073, it has to be between 25 and 43, this number. And how can we say that? Because 2 into 6 is equals to 12. Similarly, 3 into 4 is also equals to 12. So we can see that we have increased a number here. So we have to go down this side, the answer, to keep the product equal. So for 1073, the last number is 3. So 1 into 3, 7 into 9. These are the two pairs we have to search for. So let us search the pair for 7 to 9. So here we see 37, 19, 29 and 47. 37 into 29 is 1073. So we get A is equals to 19, B is equals to 29 and C is equals to 37. We can see it from here. The common thing, which is B, is 29. This is A is 19 and C is 37. Because as these are prime number, they cannot be broken down further. The question asks for the sum of these three numbers, which is 85. Hence, C is the answer. And this type of questions look difficult because it is difficult to find the factors of such numbers. But you should try this method. You should find the factors of the closest possible number to these numbers and then somehow limit your area of finding the factors. Moving forward to the question number second. Question 2. Find the greatest number of 5 digits which when divided by 3, 5, 8, 12 leaves 2 as remainder in each case. Okay. So greatest number of 5 digits is, now we simply have to take the LCM of 3, 5, 8 and 12, which comes out to be 120. On dividing 99,999 by 120, we get 39 as remainder. If we minus 39 from 99,999, we get a number which is divisible by 120. And this number comes out to be 99,960. As per the question, we have to find a number which leaves a remainder of 2 when it's divided by 3, 5, 8, 12. We'll add 2 to the number which we have found out to be divisible by 120. And this is the number which leaves remainder 2 when divided by all of them. Question 3. A milkman produces 3 kinds of milk. On a particular day, he has 170 liters, 102 liters and 374 liters of the 3 kinds of milk. He wants to bottle them in bottles of equal sizes so that each of the 3 varieties of milk will be completely bottled. How many bottle sizes are possible such that the bottle size in terms of liter is an integer? As per the question, we have to find the HCF of 170, 102, 374. And as we can see, 17 is the factor which is present in all 3 of these numbers. Further simplifying, we see that 34 is the HCF. So HCF is 34. And on finding the factors of 34, we get 1, 2, 17 and 34 itself. There are 4 possible bottle sizes in which the milk could be filled. Question 4. Find the greatest number consisting of 6 digits, which on being divided by 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 leaves 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 as remainders respectively. There are 2 types of problems involving remainders. One in which the remainder of all the given numbers is same, like the problem we have solved. And second one in which the remainder of every number is different. In such cases, what we do, we minus the remainder from the number itself. 6 minus 4 gives us 2. 7 minus 5 gives us 2. 8 minus 6. 9 minus 7, 10 minus 8, and here we see that 2 is the common number which we get when we minus the remainder from the number itself. And as we have to find the greatest 6 digit number divisible by LCM of these 5 number, LCM is 2520. And after finding the greatest 6 digit number divisible by this, we have to minus 2 from that number so as to get these remainders respectively. Greatest possible 6 digit number is, and we have to find a number which is divisible by 2520. So just for an idea, we see if we multiply 2500 by 400, we get, so we know that we have to multiply 2520 by a number somewhere around 400. Hence we get 2520 to 396 equals to 99792 0. And as I have told you earlier, you have to minus 2 from the greatest 6 digit number which is divisible by 2520 to get a number which gives these remainders when divided by these numbers respectively. And this is the trick that you have to remember to solve such questions where The remainder of each number is different. You have to subtract the remainder from the given number and then you have to subtract the common term from the number you find that is divisible by LCM of these numbers compositely. Question 5. A gardener had a number of plants to plant in horizontal rows. At first, he tried to plant 5 shrubs in each row, then 6 and then 8 and then 12, but had always one left. On trying 13 in one row, he had none left. What is the smallest number of shrubs that he could have had? Here, the numbers in which he planted his plants are 5, 6, 8 and 12. LCM is 120. And as per the condition given in question, we see that 120k plus 1, this number is divisible by 13. So, we will put the values of k and try. So, we will put values of k and try what is the minimum number of shrub that he could have. On putting k is equals to 1, we get 121, which is clearly not divisible by 13. If k is 2, then we get 241, still not divisible by 13. K is 3, 361, not divisible by 13. When k is 4, we get 481, which is divisible by 13. And hence, the smallest number of shrubs he could have is 481. And 481 gives remainder of 1 when divided by 5, 6, 8 and 12 respectively. Hope you guys find this video beneficial. And for more such videos on various quant related topics, do follow our channel.